Hello, my friends. Welcome back. I am going to be demoing watercolor portrait. This is one of the ways that I do it. There's several different methods, but this is how I'm gonna, what I'm gonna demonstrate today. All right, so I'm using 140 Arches cold press paper, and I've got my basic colors that I'm going to be using for this portrait is cadmium red light and cadmium yellow light. It's just going to be a tiny bit of alizarin crimson for the lips. I'm going to use that just a tiny bit mixed in with the cad red. I'm also using a tiny bit of a cerulean blue for the eyes. And let's see what else. I might use I will be using some burnt sienna, ultramarine blue, and raw umber. Okay? So, one of the things that I don't usually do this. This is not necessarily what you have to do, but I did in this, the white of the eyes, I have protected them with this. It's called a fine line applicator, and it has the liquid frisket in it. It's got a tiny little metal so that I was able to just isolate the white of the eyes. Like I said, it's not necessary to have this little tool. Usually I just avoid the white of that I want to avoid. I just paint around it. But I thought I would try that today. All right, so I like to go ahead and prepare the subject by just painting some water over it. This is splitting a little bit, so okay, get a bigger brush. This helps to make the paper a little more receptive to the pigments. I don't drench it, but I do paint. So it just has a little bit of a glistening to it. I'm doing a little more to the hair area because a little more water, because I will be painting there eventually, so it has a little more time to dry. Okay, so now that's just clear water. So now what I'm going to do is I'm coming here with a mixture of the yellow and the cadmium. It's kind of fun to paint right over the eyes because I have it masked. Now the area where the hair is, there is going to be some hair showing, some flesh showing through the curls. So it's all right if you paint some flesh tones in that area. Okay. So I'm going to let that dry a little bit. And I'm going to do a little bit of, while that's drying, I'm going to do a little bit of the hair. And I mix with the ultramarine blue and the raw umber. I get this wonderful gray, and it's a warm gray because it's got a little bit of kind of a little red in it. Now her hair is kind of backlit, so there is some very soft edges, kind of flighty hairs, and there's certain areas that have a little more kind of airy. I like to call it, when you can see light through it, and I like to call it like kind of a lacy look, like lace, because it's got holes in it. That's what I think of it as anyways. And so think of this as doing it in layers. With watercolors, the paint, after you put it on, will, after it dries, it will get quite a bit lighter. So it's good to keep in mind. So now I'm just going to start at this point. It's kind of all in the midtones. I'm going to start squinting my eyes to block out some of the detail, and then I can start seeing where the darkest darks are. And in this case, it's right here underneath her jawline. It's quite a bit dark in there. So I used a little more water to do this area on the my left, because it is dark, but not as much. So I diluted the same value, my burnt sienna and raw umber. So that I keep my darks on my right side. Or it might be your left side, I'm not sure. And now I come back in here to keep that soft edge. Now, one thing that you probably, if you noticed, I have this paper napkins right next to me. I couldn't paint without that or a sponge. It's kind of important to have something like that, where you can take, it helps to regulate the amount of paint in your brush. See, like this here. And then right in here, take the excess wet, excess pigment or water off your brush. Now the edges, there's a softness where the edges are that I like to keep. I came in with a smaller brush and try to soften that edge with clean water. And I always recommend to have a little bit of just a paper of the same type that you're using to test out your colors, and sometimes also the degree of wetness in the brush, of degree of how much water you have in there. It's a good idea sometimes to check that out. Okay, so now got this side. Now let's do a little bit. Her whole face, not all face, but mostly around, it has some really nice warm, it's kind of a peachy color. I think of it as kind of a shrimp. And then again on the edges, see, I'm softening them up quite a bit. trying to make this edge a little fuzzy so it's not so edgy, but it's a little softer edge. So I'm coming in here with my brush, the tip of my brush, clean water, and just touching that edge a little bit, dancing it. Okay, now I'm going to use a little more raw umber and the burnt sienna. Or you could use raw umber and cad red. That also works, because this area here is quite dark. That's the cast shadow of her face, her jaw, of her, the jawline is casting a shadow in there. So that's going to be quite a bit dark. And it's almost, and also on the one side of the neck, there's a bit of a cast shadow. It's a little stronger also than the rest. Now I'm touching it before the paint dries so that it can soften, soften that edge and soften this edge still. As long as it hasn't dried, you have a window of opportunity where you can manipulate the paint the way you want to. Now that is going to be background, so I am going to also fussy this up a bit so that when I come in with the greenish background, it will, that's what's going to give it that edge there. Okay. So let me see if I can soften this edge also. Okay, I think that works. All right, so now I'm going to come in here. It almost looked like a shape of a heart. The cast shadow underneath her nose. It's a little red right now. We're going to soften that edge. gonna do a little bit of the lips. I start from the center out to the edges. And also all the edges all around the mouth are soft. And then we're going to be thinking about the values, even the mouth, the whole mouth, there's lights, mediums, and darks. There's hard edges and soft edges, but mostly soft edges. So right now it's just one layer. When you come back and revisit that area. Okay, now this underneath has dried, so I can come in and emphasize that a little more. Okay. And revisiting here past that edge, softening it a little bit. I still want that change in value, but I want it to be with a soft edge. And so by kind of hitting both sides, it's softening it. See? I'm going both sides of the edge. Okay. At the same time, I come back here with the raw umber and add a little more value, darker value to this area. So I start very dark here next to the jaw and I soften it, and as I go down it decreases in value. So you don't have to get that red on the hair. I just had kind of a big chunk of paint in there. And so This is where I love the point of the brush when you're doing. Things like eyebrows and things like that. This is a square shader. It's a bit of a, it's a synthetic. It's a little bit stiff. And I like to use it to sometimes clean up an edge. Every once in a while, you're gonna need to spray. Also depends on the day, what kind of day it is. If it's too dry or humid, just give it a little spray to keep your paint open a little bit longer, easier to use. Now, in order for me to try to keep my edges soft in situations like this, I'm starting from the inside, that's in this case of the eyebrow. So then the water helps me to spread the paint just a tiny bit to the edge. See that? I'm getting up the paint and just kind of tickling it, touching it a little bit, and it just spreads itself to the edge. little bit of shading right here. That eyebrow, the edge of that eyebrow seems to be have a little wider to it, a little wider than how I have it. So I'm coming back, adding just a tiny bit more width to it. Not so point, it's pointy, but it's not so pointy. Okay, I think that's good. And then there's a little shadow that kind of almost connects. It's a warm shadow. Very thin layer of a warm color in here. It's a different value, but the transition is very subtle. Okay. Okay, it's just a tiny bit of an edge, wavy edge, so we fix that right away. All right, same thing over here. I'm going to add just a tiny bit of raw umber to the tip of that brush, mixed in with the burnt sienna. So I actually didn't go right to the edge. I just stayed kind of inside here. This is just a clean brush. I'm using it more because of the tip. It just has like a water tip. But any brush will do as long as it's got a little bit of it's soft but it has a little snap to it. It should work just as well. So I'm using it to pick up some paint. Okay. So while that is drying, I'm going to start doing a little more work. I'm going to revisit this area down here, let that dry for a little bit, and then we'll come back to it. So I'm using a warm burnt sienna and the raw umber for the nostril area, just right here. And then the cast shadow, which is very dark and it is a warm color. So I'm softening that edge a bit. And with a little alizarin crimson. And I'm going to add some raw umber to it to darken it. And the same thing I'm doing is I'm starting from the inside out to the edges to keep those edges as soft as I can. Okay, so I'm going to reload with raw umber. And the upper lip is usually darker, has a dark shadow. especially when you go to the corners of the mouth, more so in that area. Now, when I'm doing this highlight here, I like to go lift some color kind of in this vertical strokes. So always paint following the grain, so to speak, of whatever it is that you're painting. Think of it as wood grain. So I'm going to do that, and I know it's going to lighten quite a bit. So that'll be a good thing. Okay, so for now we're going to leave that alone. Let me see, I'm going to soften this edge while it's still wet. Okay, come back again. Okay, so now it's another time to come and reassess this jaw area. Bring it in a little more. I'm actually adding just a tiny bit of yellow to that blue to give me almost like a blue-green ice. Which is what I okay, so now I'm going to do some eyeliner and I'm going to come here and use the Raw Umber Ultramarine Blue mixture and I'm going to roll my brush and pull towards me to get that point. And you can test it out somewhere. See if it's doing what you want it to do. It's a good idea. Okay. So now, here we go. That might be a little wet. Let's try to do it in here. Okay, so I darkened that cast shadow on her nose, underneath her nose. I'm gonna come back in here where her lips are, give her a little more color in there, a little more warmer lips. See how fast that faded? Okay, I'm going to come back, add a little more dark value and color, the cast shadow from her own lips. Her lips, it's casting a shadow right here and lower and upper lip. Okay, now we're going to come back to that again when this dries. Okay, let's see. I'm going to use this pointy brush. Give her a bigger highlight and softer. All right. So now, let's see, there's an area. Yeah, we had too much blue, so we were able to clean that up a little bit. Remember, I put some masking in there to protect the white. I'm lifting some color where the highlight is. Where the highlight from the eye, and I may even have to come back later on and use that little gel pen to accentuate that highlight even more. Okay. I'm gonna keep that very soft. Right in there. Make this, I'm gonna try to make her nose a little bit narrower in here. So always look at the highlight. I'm softening this, so now your highlight is narrower in here, which is what she has, this portrait. You all have the study, I think. If you don't, you can leave me a message in the comments or send me an email. I can send it to you on the email. But all right, now I think I need to get a little deeper with her eyes. take the excess off, and then I just bring it a less amount because I just took the excess pigment and water off. Now I can just drag just the right amount. There's a little white area in here that I like to leave. Kind of open. And also in here. There's another, and so I'm pushing some of that pigment so I can have that little bit of lighter value in that area of the eyes. It's kind of subtle, but it is there. Okay, so I'm still, remember, I'm going inside. If I need to add more color to the eyebrow, so I'm going in the middle of it and going out. It helps me to keep my edges soft. Adding a little bit of yellow to my cat red and pretty good amount of water to dilute it to the right little pink flesh tone. Okay, I think I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop right now, and I may continue. I will continue for the second, for the hair and the rest of the, I'm gonna take this. This is the unmasking of the teeth, and I'm going to unmask the eyes. And I'm going to come back. There's still a pretty good amount to do. Going to get a little bit lighter in color. And the colors I'm going to be using for the hair is going to be the Raw Umber and Ultramarine Blue. I'm going to block it in for now. Okay, I'm going to stop because I don't want to run out of tape. So I will make sure that I have enough to continue, and I will be right back. Okay, thank you. See you later.